Lord can give, to match the holy word. Father, sometimes it can be very difficult, Father, to try to present. But Lord, I just ask and pray that you please be with Brother Eddie as he tries to deliver something. And Father, I ask and pray that you bless the reading of your word, Father. Just give us all knowledge, wisdom, and understanding, Father. Help us to learn more about you so that we can be better and do better for you. So bless this time. Be with Brother Eddie as he brings this. And again, we thank you so much for your precious word. In the name of your Son, Jesus. Amen.
Thank you. Revelations is a book that's it's full of literal things that happens. It's repetitive like all the rest of the scriptures are, just like Matthew, Mark, Luke, and John. It's repetitive for the stories throughout the Bible. So is Revelation's repetitive for what is in the Old Testament. And from chapter to chapter, it's a symbolic book of signs. So I want to start with verse number 7 of chapter 12. I think Tim ended up somewhere close there. And I'll turn the page here probably. But this war is going on in heaven. You got war in heaven, you got war on earth, and you got wrath. And war is in heaven, wrath is on earth. And now this war that's going on in verse 7 is not the same war that you heard Satan talk about when him and the third of the angels was cast out of back in verse 4. That was the devil's first attempt to take over the throne of God. And that war was between the angels and Satan. He didn't fight God. And God don't fight wars. He wins wars. You know, all he does is speak and it's over with. It's right there for the angels to take care of. Michael was an archangel. I never knew what an archangel was. Probably still don't have a full concept of it, but I think an archangel has angels that's working for him. He's the leader of the army, sir. And he's there protecting Israel. The war between Michael and his angels and the dragon and his angels. Let me get back here and find where they numbered these in order, I know. And there was a war in heaven. Michael and his angels fought against the dragon, and the dragon fought against his angels. You notice there it says Michael and his angels. That's kind of where I get that Michael, the archangel, has angels under him. He's in charge of some. Well, Satan's in charge of them too there. And they prevail not, and was their place found any more in heaven. That's his last trip to heaven right there. This is the second battle, I believe. It's not the battle we read about where he's cast down to earth. This is a battle where he's cast down to earth and contained there. This battle was probably set off by, I believe, the rapture, when the saints was going up. I think he went up with them trying to stop them from getting into heaven. And that's just an opinion. I'm allowed to have a few of those, I hope. But when the trump of God comes along, a trump of God, that's a trump is the sound of a trumpet makes. But God's not in this battle. Satan's last visit there, as we move on down to number 8, and there it prevailed not, neither was their place found any more in heaven. And the great dragon was cast out, and the old serpent called the devil, Satan, to deceive